I thought I'd give you guys a look at the completed chassis of the white GE set, and it's all back together, it's all done. And it plays perfectly as well. Take you around the chassis here. This one got off to a strange start. As I mentioned in another video, I like to measure across the power cord with the radio turned on with an ohm meter before I apply power to it. And, you know, I do that just to see if I have continuity. And if I do, I should have maybe 200 to 300 ohms, which indicates the resistance across the tube filaments. Well, I didn't have any continuity whatsoever when I checked it. It was wide open. So, to see where the open circuit was, I checked the power switch, the ohm meter. It was fine. Same goes for, you know, measuring across the heater string. I think I got like 250 ohms, which is spot on. That leaves only one other thing, and that is the original power cord. Yes, believe it or not, the power cord hasn't opened in it somewhere. It is broken somewhere. So I replaced that and everything was fine. I believe that in addition to this radio being all original, it is also pretty low hour. These are the caps that came out of it. They all look really good. They're not melty. And when I checked them for leakage, they didn't have any leakage. So that tells me it must not have been played for too awful long. I also worked on a cabinet today. I'll show you the finished result on that when the paint's done drying. But I think it turned out okay.